Now comes the management of gout or treatment of gout. There are two issues: how we treat an acute attack, what we do in between attacks, and how we treat chronic tophaceous and renal involvement of the gout. Acute attack must be terminated with the use of non-steroidal anti-inflammatory agents. These have to be used to the maximum tolerated dose. They are called the anti-inflammatory dose of non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs. The commonly used drug in case of gout is indomethacin, 25 to 50 milligrams BID, or it may be increased up to 100 milligrams per day. Or any other anti-inflammatory drug, for example, ibuprofen, diclofenac, naproxen, piroxicam, any drug can be used, but most commonly used drug is indomethacin. The second drug that is available for treatment of acute attack is the age-old colchicine. Colchicine can be given in a dose of 0.5 milligrams orally every 2 hours and up to a dose of 6 milligrams in a day, in the first day. How does it act? It is a neutrophil microtubular assembly inhibitor. So the neutrophils phagocytize the needle-shaped crystals there, and that crystal elicits a response in the neutrophil and produces several chemokines and cytokines. And this particular drug inhibits the microtubular assembly of the neutrophil, so much so the inflammatory materials are not produced by the neutrophil and the macrophage. Only one important feature while treating with colchicine is we need to stop the drug as soon as we see the side effect. The side effects could be diarrhea or vomiting. Can be used for chronic cases, but the only problem is the risk of bone marrow suppression is there. Usually nowadays, colchicine is not used for acute attacks unless NSAIDs are not tolerated well. The third important way of treating an acute attack could be if it is a monoarticular involvement or podagra or any other single joint, aspiration of the joint, arthrocentesis, followed by administration of intra-articular corticosteroids, IAS. Intra-articular steroids, either dipamedrol or solimedrol or triamcinolone or sometimes even decadron, can be injected into the joint space. This relieves the pain instantaneously and there will be good relief. Or where we consider not intra-articular steroids but oral steroids as the immediate step, prednisolone in a dose of 30, 40 or up to 60 milligrams per day is given up to 1 to 2 weeks and then slowly tapered off. We can use also ACTH in a dose of 40 to 80 units intramuscular or IV, or solimedrol injection IM. Opiates and Tylenol are, these are for analgesia. Tylenol is paracetamol. Paracetamol and opiates are useful as adjunct analgesics. So once again, the treatment of acute attack, the primary stay of treatment is NSAID. Indomethacin is the usually chosen drug. Colchicine can be given in those who are not responding to NSAID or who could not tolerate NSAID, or when NSAID is contraindicated. Colchicine acts by microtubular assembly inhibition. Joint aspiration for monoarticular gout can be tried along with injection of intra-articular steroid, or sometimes oral steroids can be tried like prednisolone, given for a week or two and then tapered off. ACTH can also be given for acute relief of symptoms. Other supportive analgesics like Tylenol and opiates can be tried. Here is a small little treatment algorithm for acute gout. First of all, the diagnosis of gout should be confirmed. How do we confirm? Clinically, the patient should have at least 6 of the 11 criteria which we have listed. The confirmatory diagnosis is by aspiration of the joint fluid and demonstrating the negatively birefringent crystals of urate under the polarizing light microscope. So once the diagnosis is confirmed, the next question is the patient suitable for NSAID use? Are there any contraindications for NSAID like renal insufficiency, PUD, peptic ulcer disease, CHF, or NSAID intolerance history, or could not tolerate NSAIDs once you have started. If none of these are there, then of course NSAIDs are the first choice anti-inflammatory drugs for acute gout, and the dose should be anti-inflammatory dose, little higher than analgesic dose. Then, supposing there are contraindications for NSAID use, then are corticosteroids contraindicated? This we have to very carefully assess. If the patient has got no contraindication for corticosteroid, oral corticosteroids can be given. Or you can see, when we decide on the corticosteroids, either oral or intra-articular, then the question is how many joints are involved. If only one joint is involved, mono-articular involvement like podagra or any other joint, aspiration, arthrocentesis with intra-articular corticosteroids, or per-oral corticosteroids also supplemented. More than one joint, oral steroid or intra-articular steroid. But of course, if there are contraindications for both NSAIDs and for the corticosteroids, then of course the drug of choice for acute treatment would be oral colchicine. Okay, the first line of treatment is NSAIDs. If NSAIDs are not contraindicated, then of course the steroids. Steroids can be given intra-articular, depending on the number of joints involved. If it is one joint, intra-articular steroid; more than one joint, oral steroid. Supposing both steroids and NSAIDs are contraindicated, then you can think of oral colchicine. This is the treatment algorithm for acute gout. The acute attack subsides in a week or two with treatment as listed above. But then what do we do to control further attacks, to prevent further attacks? Modification of diet. So we should know what diets are containing high purine. What are the high purine foods? All meats, including the organ meats like liver and others, meat extracts and gravies, all seafoods, yeast and yeast containing foods like yeast extracts, beer and other ethanol containing beverages, the leguminosia family, beans, peas, lentils, etc., oatmeal, and among the vegetables, spinach, asparagus, cauliflower and mushrooms. These foods are very rich in protein, and a patient of hyperuricemia and gout should reduce intake of high purine foods. Then you may ask us, what are the foods which contain low purine? All your beverages like coffee, tea, milk, then your soft drinks, your carbonated drinks, tomatoes, all vegetables other than those which are listed here, all, and then any of these wheat, rice, they do not contain any of the purines in large quantities, so they can normally be taken. Preventing further attacks is a part of treatment of acute gout, because after the acute gout, after some years, the chronic tophaceous gout can occur and recurrent acute attacks may occur. So we have to prevent the acute attacks. For that, as we have seen in the previous slide, there are certain steps that one need to take. You can call them as prophylaxis for chronic gout or the in-between attacks treatment. That is, diet low in purine, particularly seafoods and meat, and this can reduce uric acid level up to 1 milligram. If the patient is obese, weight loss is essential. Limit the consumption of alcoholic beverages, particularly beer. Modification of the medications, particularly avoiding salicylates, diuretics and niacin, particularly thiazide diuretics, and then the loop diuretics need to be changed or avoided or reduced. In patients with frank heart failure where diuretics are essential, the risk-benefit ratio has to be assessed, and diuretics can be continued on an intermittent basis or on low doses.